everyone, FusedMyKamanacha, and today I hope you're as excited as I am to be playing around with mobile VR and positional tracking. Now, this technology has been kind of exclusive to PC VR, so I'm really excited to have positional tracking on the Gear VR. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that this is currently only working on the Samsung S8 and the new Gear VR using ARCore. And if you want a tutorial that has an in-depth explanation on how ARCore works, I recommend checking out our previous tutorial on shooting stars where we go into all the components and how they're used within ARCore. So with that out of the way, let's just kind of dive into Unity to see how we can quickly set up positional tracking to work within Gear VR. Awesome, so we're here in Unity. If you want to follow along, this project is on GitHub and a link in the description. And also, if you're looking for the ARCore shooting star tutorial, that's also a link in the description below. So let's get started here. If we go look at the project, we're on the demo one scene. You can find that within low poly environment and then demos. This is the scene that you saw originally from the teaser clip. And you can see here, it's kind of already set up for ARCore. You have the particles here, which is this point cloud. And then we have ARCore device set up. These were copied from the example scene, and specifically here we can we just moved those two game objects into the scene, and everything else was from demo one. So now moving on to the inspector, you can see here we have two components on our ARCore device, and we need to tweak these a little bit in order to get it to work with the Gear VR as opposed to working on just say a flat screen on your mobile phone. So the first one here, and this is where we make most of our changes, is the tracked pose driver. Now, this is basically in part of Unity's XR package, and it basically allows us to add positional or rotational tracking to pretty much any object within our XR settings. So first thing here is we can choose a device, might be a controller, could be a remote. The next one here is the pose source, and this is just going to be set to a color camera. Both of those stay the same from what is usually used for ARCore, but these last three are what is actually different. So first up, we have the tracking type. We can either have rotation or rotation position or just position. We're going to use only position. The reason for this is that Gear VR, if we're just using the native built-in Unity controls, automatically provides us with rotational tracking. So if we have the rotational tracking from ARCore, that'll basically duplicate our rotations, which we don't really want to have happen. So let's just use the position from ARCore and the rotations from the Gear VR. Next up here, we have the update type. In the example scene, it's set to just before render, but really by default, if you just add a tracked pose driver, it defaults to update and before render. Basically what this is doing is it samples the positional tracking from the camera at before the actual rendering happens as well as during your update frame. So you basically get two sample points per frame, which allows your positional tracking to be a lot better and be a little more accurate. It does come at a performance cost, but if you're looking for very high accurate 30 plus frames per second positional tracking, this is where you want to look. And last but not least is the relative transform. This is basically saying based on wherever ARCore starts, moving relative to that, which makes complete sense because we never know where we're gonna initialize. So that's it for the tracked pose driver. The next one here is the session component, and this is specific to ARCore. First up, we have the default session config. This is just a file that you can manipulate. Let me go ahead and click on it. It's like, do you want AR background enabled? Do you want plane finding? Do you want point clouds? If you disable some of these, then you're going to save a little bit on performance. For our specific purposes, we're going to keep them all enabled. If you want positional tracking, then you definitely have to make sure that AR background is enabled. Otherwise, you're not going to get it. So it's going back to session component. The other one here that's really important is this first person camera. You'll see that it's set to none, and that's for good reason. So if we actually go ahead and double click on this to open it up, and just look for a camera, this first person camera here. This is what is used by ARCore to set the background render mode. What that means is because ARCore is an AR application, it wants to render the real world camera. And so it takes wherever your virtual camera is and will start if you have a camera reference, it'll start adding frames from your real world camera into it. However, if you set it to none, it's not going to do that. So if you just want your skybox to render or anything else in the background to render, you need to make sure this is set to none. Actually, if you take a look here, you'll see that if you do assign a camera, that we get a real world view within the GearVR. It does appear a little distorted, I'll be honest, but if you do want to see the world around you with a kind of pass-through effect, that's what that's going to look like. So that pretty much does it for all the setup we need to do within our own scene. The only other thing you'll need to do for the GearVR within your project is making sure that you have an OSIG file. You can see here I have some of my own OSIG files for different devices. If you want to build this, you'll need to make sure you have an OSIG file. You can go to the Oculus website to actually get that set up. And with that, that's everything we need to do for the project. Let's just go quickly to our build settings. Make sure you have Android set up because this is ARCore. In other settings, you'll just need to make sure you have package ID and all of this good stuff that you kind of traditionally need to do for any Android app. Definitely making sure that you have the minimum at 7.0 because you need NuGet to actually run this. And the other thing that's really important is the Xor settings right here. So you can see we have both ticked the virtual reality support for Oculus because we're running the GearVR. And we also have ARCore supported enabled. So it's interesting that a lot of things are starting to move in this is XR settings. You can see there's probably some Vuforia stuff coming and probably a lot more. So really cool to see this being a part of actually Unity. This is probably a good point to also, this is only as of Unity 2017.2. Previous versions did not have this. So that's something to keep in mind. So that's really all you need to do to set up. Before I just tell you to go and build and run it, at the top level here, you'll see that we have a sample position. So this is just, if you want a bare bones test, then you can try that out. It's just really a bunch of cubes in here. You can add whatever you want. Again, really, it's only these two that are really what's enabling ARCore to work. And then we have the Fps script. So again, at the intro video, you might have seen like a little Fps reader at the top. What I was calculating here was basically how many frames per second was ARCore updating compared to rendering. So this is called in the update frame. And you can see here, I left a little note that the max Fps that update is going to run at is 60 Fps. That's just a limitation of the GearVR and the display refreshing at 60 Fps. So when we calculate our AR FPS, we are really only calculating at most 60 frames per second. The AR FPS could be a little higher, it could be a little lower. It could be a little lower and we'll see it, but if it's higher, we won't be able to see it because update is only refreshing at most 60 frames per second. So we'll be able to see what at most it's refreshing at. Again, these are kind of approximate values. I'm not really like, let's count up the number of frames each second and report that value. We're just kind of saying like how much time is happening between each frame and then updating the, just based on that updating how much we think would happen over 60 seconds. So it's not perfect, but it does give you a rough estimate of how this is working. So you can take a look here. Again, if you want to learn more about ARCore and kind of what this frame is, anything like that, definitely go check out the other tutorial that I mentioned. So let me just go ahead and close that. Pretty much, you're pretty much set to go. Just go ahead and go to your build settings. Make sure whatever you've seen you want, it should default if you're just grabbing this off of GitHub. Go ahead, if you have your phone attached, go ahead and hit build and run, and then check it out. I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. It's actually surprisingly easy now to get positional tracking working on mobile, which is really, really cool. Again, this only works with the S8, and the new GearVR, but hopefully ARCore will be opening up to more phones soon because it's currently in beta. If you like this video, make sure to share it with a friend because that helps us out a ton. And if you haven't, go check out our ARCore Shooting Stars tutorial where we give a more in-depth explanation of how ARCore works. Until next time, this has been FusedVR, and I'm signing out.